Good afternoon, sir. My name is Yeah, I'm calling you from Products. Are you having any kind of problems there with your septic tank, sir?
You know, between me and my other two roommates, we go to the bathroom a lot. Mm-hmm. More than, you know, ordinary people. So I know, you know, we clog up the toilet a lot. Because we take a lot of dumps.
Mr. Price.
But you got to see the size of these logs, though. And the toilet, you know, a lot of times it won't even flush.
Okay.
All the logs are sticking out of the water. It's disgusting.
Yeah. Right, I can understand and picture that.
You ever get one that gets out of the water?
Yeah.
Yeah, you look like you're waiting for a frog to, like, jump into the water off of it.
Do you notice any odors coming in from the outside?
Most of the odors are just coming from the bathroom.
Just in the bathroom. Is it coming from the drains?
No, it's coming from the toilet, from the logs.
From the toilet. That's just an odor that just gets created there momentarily.
No, it's there for a while. I mean, some of my dumps really linger.
Just out of curiosity, you're throwing your toilet paper down the commode?
Usually you have to throw it in another bag because
okay.
There's so much crap in the toilet.
Okay. Trust me, those odors that you're noticing are not really, they're lingering. They're coming in from the drains, okay?
Believe me, some of it doesn't even go down the toilet,
well,
you know?
Let me ask you a question.
Sometimes we got to chop the turds up with a shovel.
Yeah, I can
so
understand that.
It's not just, it's coming from the turds in the toilet.
Okay. But have you ever used these products before?
No, but how are we going to get it in the toilet with all the...
Flush it.
But the turds are going to be in the way.
Don't flush it when there's turds in the way, okay?
Well, it always is, though. That's the problem.
Mr. Price.
Yesterday, I couldn't even go in the regular toilet. I had to take an upper decker.
Okay.
You know, I had to take the top of the tank, that part. I took the top off, and I had to take an upper decker in there because there was no room below.
Is that still there in the upper decker?
Probably. I don't know. I just put the lid back on. I haven't looked.
Listen. If you want to put your life back to a normalcy in that house, okay, you want to try this product.
How is it going to chop up the turds, though?
It liquefies it. You got to get those turds out of the way.
I'm not touching them.
Okay.
Most of them aren't even mine. I mean, I could pick the ones out of the mine, but mine usually the ones with corn in them. Because I eat a lot of corn.
Yeah. The most important thing is you got to get this stuff flushed down in there, okay? Otherwise, it's never going to clean up.
Okay, how do you suggest I get them out of the way?
With a shovel. Just get it up, pick it up with your hands, put a glove on, whatever.
Okay, but where do I put them if I use my hand or a shovel?
Forget about the turds. Just pick them up and throw them away. Bury it. Whatever. What do you care?
Would you pick up turds?
I never had to pick up anybody else's turds before.
Okay, I mean, so it's not that easy to say, just go pick up the turds, but they're not, most of them are mine.
Listen carefully. This product right here is going to guarantee to dissolve those turds that are floaters, okay? Your girlfriend will enjoy life a whole lot better when she comes visit, all right?
I know, it's embarrassing. I got to send her to the gas station to go to the bathroom.
Those turds don't belong to you.
You want me to just pick them up my hand, or do you want me to take them out?
Put your hand, put a little rubber glove on it.
You want me to, like, hold them up like I caught a fish, too, when I'm done?
Yeah, whatever. Just get them out of the way, Mr. Price. The whole thing is that you got to put this down the drain, okay? That's it.
You know how...
Listen, after 30 days, if you see your toilet is flushing completely through, even with the size and amount of turds you got in there, okay? If you got rid of the stink, okay? If you're starting to live a little better.
I'm not touching anybody else's turds.
Okay, I'm not asking you to touch anybody else's turds.
Yes, you are, because I told you this. All three of ours are in there.
Then talk to your roommate.
They already said they're not touching it. They don't care. They just keep doing it right on top of the other ones.
Don't touch their turds. All right, let me tell you something, Mr. Price.
Mine, the ones that have the corn in them, are underneath there. So how do I get to mine?
Forget the corn. Listen.
No, but how do I get to my turds?
I don't know whose turds belong to who.
I know which ones do.
How about I call you next week after you get the turds and the corn out of the way?
No, but the problem is mine are underneath. I have to move theirs to get to mine.
Okay. Listen.
How am I supposed to move them?
Move them with your little hand. Come on.
What do you mean my little hand? Both hands are the same size.
Let me tell you something. I have a special on a pooper scooper. I'm going to call you back on that price right now. Okay, hold on.